Hello there. Welcome to part 3 of this tutorial. Today, I'm going to be adding enemies, as well as enemy movement and shooting. Hope you enjoy. We can start by creating our enemy. This will be similar to how we made our player. First, we'll need to create a new scene, click on other node and add a kinematic body, a collision shape, and a sprite. Now we can add the enemy image. I'll rotate it so that it's facing left and make it a bit bigger. Remember to re-import it as well. That way, the quality of the image will be a lot clearer. Looking good. Now we can add the collision shape. I'm going to be using a rectangle, this will need to fit around the entire sprite. I'll call this our enemy. Now we can start adding detection. Basically, what I'd like to happen is, when the player is detected by the enemy will move toward and shoot at the enemy. In order to do this, we'll need to add an area 2D node and a collision shape. What these will do is allow the enemy to detect the player when they move inside the collision shape. We'll code this later, for now we can add the collision shape. I'm going to be adding a circle to cover a large area and so the enemy can detect the player from any angle. The enemy will be able to find the player anywhere in this area. I'll want to make the detection area pretty big so that the enemy can move towards the player as they enter the screen. I think that's good enough. Now we can add a script to the enemy. The first thing we'll need to do is create a player variable. It will be null, which means that it is empty and has no value. Now we can add a speed variable, which will control how fast we move. I'll use an export variable. What this will do is allow us to change the enemy speed without needing to go back into the code. Before we go any further, we'll need to add a group to the player. This will allow the enemy to identify the player. Go into the player scene. Click on node. Then go to group and type in a group name. I'll name the group player. Now we'll get back to coding the enemy. Go to our detection node and add a body entered signal to the enemy. This is where we'll code the detection. If the area node detects our player group, the player will be recognized. This means that the player will no longer be null, and will have a value. Now we can add a physics process function. I'll create a movement variable that moves the enemy left at a constant speed. This will allow the enemy to move without detecting the player. Remember that this will have to be negative. Now, if the player is detected, the enemy will move in the direction of the player position. Multiply by the speed variable to apply the speed. Finally, we'll allow the enemy to be collided with by using move and collide. Before we code enemy shooting, we'll need to add bullets. If you watched my last video, you should know how to do this, so I'll make it quick. Add an area 2D node, a collision shape, and a sprite. I'll import the bullet and rotate it so that it's facing left. Then I'll re-import the image. Now we can add the collision shape, which will go around the entire sprite. I'll name this enemy bullet. Now we can add a script to the bullet. Add a speed variable, which will control how fast the bullet will go. Now we can add a physics process function. Remember that we'll want our bullets to move on the x-axis. We'll also need to subtract from the assignment so that they move left. Multiply delta by our variable to apply the speed. Now, in the enemy scene, we'll need to add a position node and a timer. The position node will control where the bullet spawn. I'll move this to the end of the gun. The timer will control how fast the enemy will shoot. Remember to click auto start. I'm also going to set the wait time a bit lower. Inside the enemy script, we're going to make a preload variable. What this will do is load the enemy bullets into our game. Remember that we'll need to use the enemy bullet scene. Now we can add a can shoot variable, which will determine if the enemy can fire. We can connect the position node to the script using an onReady variable. The next thing we'll need to do is add a timeout signal. Click on the timer and add the timeout signal to the enemy. What this will do is set can shoot to true. Then, if the player is detected, the enemy will fire. Now, in the shoot function, if the player can shoot, I'll make a variable that instances the bullet. Then, we'll set the bullet spawn point equal to the position node location. Finally, we'll add the bullet to the scene. We'll also want to start the timer and set can shoot to false. Now we can add the enemy to the game. Let's go into the main scene. Click the link icon and add the enemy scene. I'll move this to the end of the game window. Great. Now the enemy can move toward and shoot the player when it is detected. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked this video and found it useful. See you later.